Hey guys, I'm Voylin and let's talk about localization support in Godot and which one to go for. I'll be talking about the different options, their use cases, ease of use and performance. I have made a video some time ago about localizing your Godot projects with PO files, so give that a watch if you want to see how that works. In Godot there are three ways of localizing your projects: CSV files, which are comma separated value files, PO files, which uses getText, and MO files. Most of you probably use or know about CSV files. Easy to use, and it is basically just a text file which can be opened in programs like Google Sheets, Microsoft Excel, and LibreOffice Calc, to name a few, or just a normal text editor. Then you have PO files, which are separate files for every single language. This uses getText, which is a popular software for localizing. For PO files, you could also use a text editor to work on them, but tools like PO Edit make it a ton easier to use the different features which PO files have to offer. Lastly, we have MO files, which are just compiled PO files. They are binary files, which are easier to read by your PC, so they should load faster into your program, as there is no text parsing which needs to happen. Let's take a look at the test projects. I basically created 500 labels, added some text to them, which will be translated around 30 times in both Japanese and English. The timings will be used to measure their performance. When looking at the code, we first await the frame post draw from the rendering server. This is to give a break to the code so the editor can catch up to displaying the changes, because otherwise it would loop through everything without giving us exact timings. Then we set the start time, change the local, set the end time, and the difference gets added to an array called tests. We can do the exact same for Japanese by changing en to ja. Before we go on to the performance numbers, let's take a look at the file sizes, as this might be interesting to some of you. For the CSV files, we have the CSV file itself, which is around 14,965 bytes. But the translation files it generates are a total of 38,665 bytes. Then we have PO files, which come in at a total of 37,661 bytes in total. And then we have MO files, which come in at 40,988 bytes in total. MO files are bigger in size. This is all in bytes, so it does not play too much of a role, as these numbers are still very low. But MO files are supposed to be easier to read by your PC, whilst PO files are easier to read by humans. So that may play a role. So if file sizes aren't something to consider, how about performance? Well, take a look at this Excel sheet. I ran my test multiple times and calculated the average, took the lowest value and took the highest value, out of which we can see that, we can't really see that much. Looking at milliseconds, the differences are basically in a margin of error. So I ran the test using microseconds instead, which reveals that the information we got is still within a margin of error. One thing we can see is that the CSV file's average is higher compared to PO and MO files, and the lowest time is higher compared to the other values. But I think we can all agree that in terms of performance and file size, making a decision on which localization method to use is the same as just blindly selecting one. And this makes perfect sense, to be honest, because PCs nowadays are very fast and these localization files are usually not too big anyway, just a couple of kilobytes, which for a PC don't really matter or impact that much. And also, these translations only need to be loaded into memory once, so this only affects performance of switching a language and starting up your project. So why should you care about which localization method to use? If you are working alone, CSV files will be more than enough, as your application will probably not scale to the point that multiple people will be working on translations anyway. And even if you do, you could use something as Google Sheets, in which multiple people can still work on it at the same time without any issues. CSV files are easy to use, easy to edit, you can't really do much wrong with them, and you can use a normal text editor or a spreadsheet program, which makes them the go-to for most people. Then why is there the whole PO and MO system? Well, localization can be as simple as just translating sentences, but with PO files you can have different localizations for plurals of words, and a good example for this could be having an entry for "there is a number of apple." And you replace the %s by 1, and then you have there is one apple. And for the plural, you can have there are %s apples, and then you can replace the %s by any number. PO files also allow you to add context to your strings, which need translating. This is personally something I think is quite nice, as it can more easily show what and how this must be translated, because in Japanese, you have different words for open depending on the situation. The biggest benefit though is that every language has its own file, making it very easy for a big team of people to work on translations at the same time, as it won't cause any issues with Git, by example. Something I also talked about in my previous localization video. If you want to use a service to help translate your games or software, you'll most likely will need to use PO files, as this is considered to be more one of the standards of localizing software. But yeah, there is one big elephant in the room for people who know PO files and work with Godot already. And that is that Godot doesn't have proper support for the features which PO files can offer, which is a shame. But hopefully this will get fixed one day in the future. Hopefully. For something like a small game or piece of software, CSV files may be more than enough. For Cosan, my video editor which I'm developing inside of Godot, I have chosen PO files, as they make it easier for contributors to work on translations without running into merge issues due to the way that Git works. But in all honesty, like, if you look at these numbers, you can tell as well as I can that there's really not much of a difference. It really does not matter which localization method you use, just go for the method that fits your use case or that you prefer working with. But yeah, I hope you learned something in this video. If you did, consider pressing the like button, and if you want to see more videos like these, you may like to be a subscriber of the channel. This video was made possible by the support of my Ko-fi supporters, and if you want to be part of these amazing people, you can go to the description where there's a link to go to my Ko-fi page. Thank you very much for supporting me. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye bye.